And now his adversary, welcoming into the cage, ladies and gentlemen, into the Road to Glory ring, please welcome Brandon Needham. Streaming live across MMA TV, sponsored by Atrium Bar and Nightclub, presenting a professional catchweight bout at 81.5 kilograms. Fought over three-minute rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man stands 6 feet 3 inches tall and weighing officially at 80.5 kilograms with a single professional win, representing Cowboy Jim from Harrogate. He is Kieran Whitehouse. And his adversary in the red corner, standing 6 feet 2 inches tall and weighing officially at 81.3 kilograms with a single win to a single defeat, from Yorkshire MMA, from Sheffield, Brandon Needham. Once again, when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. John Blackledge.
So our second bout tonight here on Road to Glory 2 is a catchweight match. It's actually matched at 81.5K, and I saw both men make weight. Kieran Whitehouse, Cowboy Jim Harrogate, coming off a professional win in his professional debut against Brendan Needham, who's 1-1, so very closely matched, these two young men.
Equal matchup, equal height, they're both tall lads. It'd be interesting to see what kind of style they've both got. I mean, we saw Joe Hemsworth, who was 6 feet two, and he fought like a guy that's 5 foot five, just coming forward with aggression all the time. Let's see what these guys do, whether they stick and move or want to tear it up.
And again, what I love about this is seeing young men starting their trade. 19, Kieran, 21, Brendan, still very young men indeed. And a big left hook to start from Brendan Needham to wake Kieran Whitehouse straight up. And it's the slightly shorter man coming forward very aggressively.
Good technique too, nice and short punches. Hasn't landed anything meaningful yet, but he's certainly, oh, there we go with the left uppercut.
The left uppercut was the one, as Howard said. And he was in the center. Kieran used that opportunity to turn his man, walking forward. You've got to be careful when you take shots like that to just walk forward. I'm all for the aggressor and coming forward, but make your opponent think about it. It was like he was stung and then just pushed forward onto more punches.
Yeah, well, Brendan Needham's having problems now is his left leg, his lead leg. He doesn't know how to defend against low kick. His leg's positioned all wrong. So every time Kieran Whitehouse throws one, it's landing flush. There you go again. He's not going to take that all fight long.
No, he's got to start checking. Well, he went to check there, and he needs to, but...
But he's got his toes turned inward like he's boxing instead of forward or outward. And so by the time he goes to turn his knee out to block, it's too late.
And Kieran settled down well after that early onslaught from Brendan. He's taken the center of the ring. And I was impressed with Brendan's boxing early, but Kieran has said, seemed to have turned it around and said, targeting that lead leg.
Yeah, well, that's a lack of experience, that big attack and having nothing after it, you know. He's not countering very well, and now he's been pushed onto the back foot. It's a different fight.
Yes, Kieran, happy to stand in the pocket there and stay better from Brendan. Both men working behind the teep now. But you feel the initiative's just changed now in favour of Kieran.
It has, and the main thing is what you're landing, what's causing the damage, and the differentiator is that low kick.
Well, again, and he's gone to the thigh as well this time, a nice little push to the thigh, the front of it. He's working all angles of that lead leg. And there'll come a stage with that height advantage well where Brendan won't know what to defend. He'll be looking for that leg, and then the hand could come over the top.
Exactly. It's that simple. There we go again. I mean, he can't defend at all. Picking his leg up makes no difference because the foot position's all wrong. Accidental low kick there to the groin.
Yes, then the subtle difference is it's no longer a check, it's just a leg lift.
That's all. Exactly that. It's that simple. And if you can't stop or put the person off attacking you with low kick, then you're going to have problems all fight long. And to have that problem in the first round, it is a problem.
So we resume the action, and Kieran again. He set out his stall now, working the side and the front of that lead leg.
Well, they've said something in the corner to Brendan, because he just made a perfect leg check. But now he's under pressure from all sorts. Attacks to the back leg as well as the front, and punches. That's a good counter.
Well, he's got good boxing skills, and I think they realise that he needs to stand his ground and stop this happening. So actually what they've decided to do is, rather than have him defend, is come forward and attack. And he has got good boxing skills. As that left shoulder, he hurt here and there with that left straight through the channel.
Attack is the best form of defence, and there you go.
As we saw in the first bout, for Brendan, I think he's at a disadvantage when he's in the corners with his back to the ropes and he's having to take those kicks. When he gets the bit between his teeth and pushes forward, he's a different athlete.
Yeah, that's when he's at his most effective. His defence isn't the best. Yeah, well, I got to score that round to Kieran, just on leg kicks alone. Because with the hands, there wasn't much difference between the two of them, to be fair. They've got similar styles.
If you look at the round overall, Brendan had a very good start with the boxing. And that last 20 seconds, that burst of boxing as well. But I agree with that. Beyond that, Kieran got into a rhythm, got the centre of the ring, and really attacked all angles of that lead leg.
He did. He was very effective when he had Brendan backed up to the ropes. Both men standing in between rounds, sign of confidence and fitness, good to see. And listening wisely to instruction. After taking those kicks to the legs, of course, you need to stand sometimes just to make sure you keep the blood flowing. You sit down, and if you bend your knees when you sit down, then it can numb your legs. You need to have them massaged, although very lightly, and have them shaken up a bit.
Round two of potential three. But the other thing that's exciting about this, Howard, is Kieran, when he comes forward like that, we've seen when Brendan does the burst, he can be caught. And if one of those heavy punches come right through his uppercut, it could turn this bout on its head.
Well, it did look like that. Brendan did sting Kieran in that first round. But he couldn't capitalise on it because it's the first round. They're both so fresh.
And again, Kieran just takes the leg. So Kieran feeling his way forward again, pushing forward with that left jab. And again, that's where he's vulnerable as well. That's the great thing. Brendan is sharp on the punching as a counter.
He is. What I like about Kieran, though, is that his attack's quite varied. He's attacking with the lead leg low kick as well and going for that back leg, which at this stage only had one contest. He's very good.
Yes, and I just noticed there as well, Howard, that just slightly after taking that last left, Brendan's thought to switch to southpaw to protect the leg, which is always a worrying sign, especially when you're just in round two here.
Exactly.
You already thought about that.
Well, psychologically, what does that do to the person attacking you?
It tells you you're getting through with that kick.
Yeah.
But I actually like Brendan when he's stung into action like this. When he feels the need and he thinks, I'm not taking this anymore, he looks a different fighter when he pushes forward.
He's got a lot of grit about him. He's got a heart. He's a brave lad. But it's hard for him to sustain the counters when that left leg is numbing up. And it is numbing up.
And as you said, Kieran very cleverly works off either leg. Oh, that one in again. Brendan, that's the second time in the second round here. But well, I was just about to say that I like the way, as you said, Kieran works off the front or rear leg.
Yeah, he's talented.
So then he targets all angles of that lead leg.
That's right. So Brendan's confused. He doesn't know where the attacks are coming from. Especially the low kick, which are giving him so many problems. Brendan's making the most of this, and I don't blame him. Get some time out, and he should be stamping that left leg just to make sure the blood keeps flowing. It does help. The kick didn't look that hard, but you just can't tell.
No.
Unless you're on the receiving end, you've no idea.
But talking of being on the receiving end, he does cause Kieran problems when he's suddenly stung into action and comes forward. I like his boxing technique.
It's very good. Nice short punches, but it's just not enough of it.
No. And again, perfectly timed teep this time from Kieran.
And again, they're both good at front kick, both of them.
Well, what I like is, as you said, he's only had the one bout which he won, but there's a nice variety already. So he's got Brendan used to defending that lead leg. Then he'll bring the teep up to the midsection.
What Brendan's now reduced mainly to boxing, and that's simply because of the damage he's taken to the front leg.
And again, when you take the damage to the front leg, what people don't realize is it will eventually impede your ability to box as well, because you need that balance, you need that platform for your punches.
It'll take the power out of your shots.
And somebody's bleeding. I don't quite sure where it's from. It's from the nose.
I think it's Brendan.
It's Brendan's nose.
Yeah. Nice catch there, but he didn't have the energy to counter.
It's a measured performance now, I think, in this second round from Kieran. It's quite a dominant performance here in the second, Howard.
Yeah, you could, if you wanted, score it 10-8 so far. He's landed that many more shots, more or less at will.
And again, it's that mobility of Brendan coming in now. Kieran showing that he's happy off the back foot, turns nicely, smiles because a couple of shots got through there from Brendan.
They did, they were decent shots as well. Good power. But he just can't sustain it. His mobility, it's gone.
Yes, and that's the difference, I feel, just between the two fighters, is the mobility of Kieran because of the way he worked at the mobility of his opponent.
That's right. You see, you take away someone's stance and balance, you're going to win. It's as simple as that. So if you've got better movement, or if they can't defend properly, as is the case in this contest, where that lead leg's taking a lot of damage to the thigh, then the mobility.